Algebra 2 Academic 5.3 and 5.4 Notes Lecture. Okay, so here's the 5.3 notes. Make sure you get your homework to me, and I'll change your attendance status. All right. Craigie is excused tardy. Okay, cool. Whew. Okay. All right, we got to get going. Okay. 5.3. Find the degree of each polynomial, state how many terms it has, and indicate whether it's a monomial, binomial, or trinomial. All right, monomial means it has, a polynomial has one term. Binomial is two terms, trinomial is three terms, okay? What's a term? In a polynomial, what is a term? A term is like the numbers that get added together, right? So this has how many terms?
One.
So it's a monomial. What's the degree? Do you know what the degree is? It's the highest exponent you can find. What's the highest exponent you can find here? One, yeah. Degree is one, one term. Which makes it a monomial, okay? Number two, or no, part B, right? Still one term, right? Yes. All right, pass it up. Still one term, right? So it's a monomial. What's the degree?
Two.
Why is it two, Denaya?
Because
the
exponent is two.
Yeah. The highest exponent you can find is a two. It's a two. Okay, C, right? How many terms do we have now?
Two.
Two, right? Two terms. So it's a binomial is what we call it. We call it a binomial. Okay, and what's the highest exponent you can find there, Sam? So what degree is my degree? So the degree is three. Degree is three.
You have to do like that if you said second degree. Where do you want
to say third degree. Yeah, you can say third degree, second degree, fourth degree, fifth degree. Put your name on, please. You can just say binomial. Yeah, okay, that's it. Yeah. D, how many terms are there here?
Three.
Three, yeah, so it's a trinomial. Because there's three terms. What is the degree?
Two.
Okay, so here's a little caveat. Okay, a little caveat, okay? There's two variables in one term right here, right? And they both have twos. When that happens, you multiply. Do you multiply them or do you add them? I think you add them.
I have a question.
Yeah.
So does you have the -4x meant to be 1? So would that be included with like the x, 2, y, 2?
Like, are they the same term or do we take it into account when we find the degree?
No, you're saying that you like multiply them because there's two, right? So do you include the other x over there?
No.
Okay.
What I'm saying is you add the exponents. You add the exponents. So the degree is four. When there's two variables in one term, the degree of that term is the sum of the exponents. And then the degree of the entire polynomial is the same as the degree of the highest degree term. Yeah, what's up? What's that? Doesn't x have an exponent?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. So you can do 5 then? No. So I'm sorry, I'm not being clear enough. So the degree of your polynomial is the degree of the is the same as the highest degree term. Okay. A term, the degree of a term is going to be all the exponents you can find in that term added together. So that's why it's 4. We're only interested in the highest degree term. The 4x is like is irrelevant here. It's completely irrelevant for the degree. What's that? No, the degree would still be 4. So the degree, I'm going to highlight this term in yellow. The degree of that term is 4. Why is it 4? Because I added the 2 exponents together yesterday.
I thought that the degree was just the
same as the highest degree term, and I should say the sum of the highest exponents. Really? That's how long this is all told me. I can look it up in the book. This is 5-3. Yep, you do add them together. Yep. So this is right. Yep, you add them together. Yep, so the degree is 4. The degree is 4 here. Okay. The degree is 4 because the degree of the highest degree term is 4. Okay, that has a degree of 4. This has a degree of 1. Okay. Right. And this yellow term has a degree of 4 because you add the exponents. Okay, so I guess that's my bad. So the degree of the polynomial is the same as the highest degree of the highest degree term, which is you add the exponents, all the exponents you see. Make sense? All right. Okay. Polynomial function. Define a polynomial function. A polynomial function is a function that only involves multiplication addition subtraction and positive exponents. So no negative exponents, there's no division of terms. You don't divide terms. Okay. Right, does that sound okay? So simplify, now we're gonna simplify. I'm gonna go on to 3 here, simplify each polynomial by combining like terms. By combining like terms, okay? So how do I simplify A, Lance? How do I combine like terms?
5x.
Yeah, it's 5x. Okay. That makes sense. This should be reviewed. Right. What about B, Berhanu? How do I simplify that? 10y minus 8y? 2y. 2y, yeah. Okay. Then deny for C, what does that simplify to?
Negative x2y plus 3x.
Yeah. Yeah, good job, right? What are like terms?
terms have the same like variable?
Say, yeah, so like terms are terms that have the same variable with the same exponents. So right here, x, y, and minus 2xy are like terms, so we can combine them, okay? 3x does not have any like terms there, unfortunately.
We're adding like terms, we don't do anything with the variable, right?
You what?
We're adding like terms, yeah, we don't do anything with
the variable. You don't change the variable to the exponent at all when you're adding or subtracting like terms, okay? For D, Thomas Mann, what are my two like terms I can combine there? What do they combine to? Or actually, there's two pairs of like terms. What do they combine to? Be 9x, right? So the second, minus 6, minus 3, negative 9, yep. Yeah, so these two terms are like to each other, right? They have the same variable x with the same exponent, and then these two terms are like. They have the same variable with the same exponent of 2. Does that make sense? Feel okay? Yeah, so these two terms are like to each other, but y to the fifth has no like terms, so we just have to leave it as is. Okay. Part f, right, I have a negative 2xy squared and an 8xy squared. Those are like terms because they have the exact same variables with the exact same exponents, okay? And then I have a 3x and a minus x. Okay. I combine the guys in pink, that gave me 6xy squared. Combine the guys in the yellow, that gives me plus 2x. It's like impossible to see. Plus 2x. Plus 2x. And then we have a minus 3/5 there. Just to check. Right? Are we okay? Bless you. Alright, add the polynomials. How do we add two polynomials? Here's my instruction for you guys. Distribute any negatives you need to. Combine like terms. Little two-step process there, right? All right. So there's no negatives I need to distribute here, and then we just combine like terms, okay? So my like terms are the minus 2y and a 2y here. And then a 5 and a 7, right? Constants are like to each other. Okay? This guy's just chilling by himself. All right, so it's minus 3y squared. These cancel, and then plus 12. All right? You guys see that? Negative 2y plus 2y, what does that equal? 0y. Yeah. Okay. B, right? B, I don't have to distribute any negatives. So, Chris, what does this simplify to?
Negative 4x squared minus 10.
Good job. Awesome. Yeah. So, Chris saw that you had these two like terms, the two second degree terms there. These two linear terms, we call those, right? They combine. Right? Pink guys combine to minus 10x, the yellow guys combine to minus 4x squared. Okay? C, this one's really easy. I'm just going to do it. It lines it up for you. So 12x squared minus 2x minus 5. Okay? Anyone having any trouble? Anyone lost? Okay, so almost. For subtracting the polynomials, right now we have to distribute some negatives, right? So you get minus 6x squared minus 3x plus 9, and then it'll be plus, and then we just, it'll be plus, and we just distribute this negative. Minus 7x minus 10. Okay, see what it did there? So I just distribute the negative and change it to an addition. Okay. Right, subtracting a positive is the same as adding a negative. Okay, that's why I do that. Okay. I get minus 6x squared minus 10x minus 1. How are we feeling?
Wait, minus
10x. Yeah, so minus 3x. Same for B, right? We can make this into an addition. So we have 4x squared minus 3x minus 15 minus plus minus 5x squared. So what I'm doing is I can, instead of just subtracting, I can distribute this negative to all three of these terms. And then make it an addition. Yeah, it is. I'm just pulling it. So subtracting these three terms is the same as adding the opposite of each of these three terms. So instead of subtracting 5x squared and subtracting negative 3x and subtracting negative 22, I can add negative 5x squared and add positive 3x and add positive 22. That's what the minus sign's like. Right? Distribute any negatives, combine like terms. We distributed our negative here, right? Flipped all my signs and added them. Alright, so 4x squared minus 5x squared, that's minus x squared. 3x minus 3x plus positive 3x is 0, negative 15 plus 22 is 7. This one, C might understand this. Okay, Macy. C. How do I do C? What's my first step? Distribute the negative, right? So what do I get when I distribute the negative? I get 2x minus 2, and then what else do I have? Yeah, plus x plus 2, right? And now I can just add it all again. Multiplication. Together, I wouldn't multiply them together because there's a minus sign here. So the multiplication sign. We'll see that in the next section. Alright. So distribute the negatives. Distributing a negative, right? Technically, this minus is technically a negative 1 here. So I distribute a negative 1. Negative 1 times negative x is positive x. Negative 1 times negative 2 is positive 2. And I have. Okay? Alright. Then number 1, 2, and 3. Match each equation with its graph. Okay? Let's start with this middle one. Number 2. Where should I write my 2 here? C has a degree of 1. The degree is 1 here, and that looks like a line in the linear equation. What about number 1? Where do I do that?
I have a question.
Yes.
So if it's linear, it's like
automatically
the degree of
1? Yeah. Polynomials of degree 1 have graphs that look like lines. Okay. Polynomials with degree of 2, so B here, that looks like what? Number 1 there, right? Polynomials with degree 2, right? Degree of 2 right there. They have graphs that look like horseshoes. I know what you call a parabola, right? Parabola. You guys saw that in algebra 1. What you didn't see in algebra 1 was polynomials of degree 3 have graphs that look like S's. Graph looks like an S. Back over A and B's, and some people I think were having a hard time with it. Okay, subtracting a polynomial is the same as adding all the opposite terms. And that's where the addition came from, right? Instead of subtracting 7x and subtracting 10, I just did adding minus 7x and minus 10. Did that help at all or no? Okay. All right. Let's go on to 5.4. Now we're going to multiply, right? Now we're going to multiply. 2x times 4x. Yeah, 8x squared. So what you do is you multiply constants together and you add the variables on, you add the exponents on the variables. You multiply two exponents together. 2 times, it's 2 times 4 times x, right? Okay. 2 times 4 is 8, x times x is x squared. You guys see that? And b, this becomes negative 6 times 5 times a squared times a cubed. Okay. It's negative 38 to the fifth. Alright, Taylor Jones, what's C? So 6 times 4.1 is 24.6, right? And then what's the rest of it?
X to the second.
Yep.
Y to the second.
Yep.
And then to the
left. Yeah. Good job. Be sure when you do this, when you're done multiplying, that you make sure you don't have any like terms left that you need to combine. All right, Jack Schneider, what about part F?
We're going to distribute the negative 2b squared z.
So what's my answer?
Negative 4b squared z to the third a,
yeah,
plus negative 2b to the third z to the second a minus, plus 2b to the third.
Yeah. Then do I have any like terms I need to combine?
No.
No, yeah. Like terms mean they have the exact same variables with the exact same exponents, which is not the case for these three terms. Yep. Good job, Jack. Here, G. Anyone know how to do G?
Me.
Yeah, okay. Mason, go for it. No, walk me through it.
Thank you.
day, Mr. Rushka.
I'm sorry. It sucks.
My sister this morning took all of her laundry because she had to do laundry. And mine was in it because yesterday was my day. She took it all out and it was still wet because it hadn't dried all the way.
She just left it somewhere?
And she just put it in a thing. And
that
so
sucks.
I made the poor decision.
She didn't move it to the dryer?
No, she just took it out. And so I made the poor decision of taking her clothes that were in the dryer and putting them in the sink.
Oh, no, no. Thanks. Gotta get back. I'm almost. I just got my gym membership back. Yes.
Oh, nice.
So,
like you more if you got a haircut.
I'm gonna get back into it.
You're gonna look like now you gotta the way the rock is.
Yeah, no, that's the goal.
You gotta make up for it.
Yeah. What?
You gotta eat.
No, I have been exercising, so I'm not eating. Once I start exercising, I'll eat a lot. I know how it works.
I don't know how it works.
Yeah,
what? What? No. Alright. 12:45, we'll see you in our lecture again. 12:45, alright. Hey, course A! Sophia, phones away, please. Sophia Fisher, how do we do part A? Guys, remember? Yeah, so, alright, Ian, Thomas, Chris, you guys remember FOIL?
No.
You don't remember FOIL? Okay, yeah, we had Algebra 1 like during the whole month.
I remember FOIL. That was too long ago.
FOIL. First. Outer. Okay. Inner.
I throw a box.
Oh, now I remember.
Last. Okay.
What?
So when we're multiplying two binomials together, we multiply the first terms together. So that gives me, it's going to give me 3x squared. We multiply the outer terms together, so x and minus 4, that gives me minus 4x. Multiply the inner terms together, 3 and 3x gives me 9x. And then multiply the last terms together, 3 and negative 4 gives me minus 12. Okay. Combine my like terms in the middle here, 3x squared. 5x minus 12. Okay, that's my final answer. Alright, so FOIL. FOIL. First, outer, inner, last.
FOIL.
Can you just use the box method?
If whatever works for you. I'll teach FOIL, use whatever works to get the right answer. So then, Thomas Mann.
Yes.
B. What'd that be?
X squared.
Yeah, first. Good job, yep, outer.
Plus 2x.
Yep, inner.
Plus 6.
Yep, last. And I kind of combine those like terms in the middle, right? Yeah, there's my answer. There's my answer.
So it's just distribute.
Yeah, it's distribute. If that
just
basically. Yeah. Times negative 6 is negative 18. One of my variables.
X squared, y squared.
Enter. Do what?
Yeah, then you do negative 4 y squared times x squared.
Yep.
And then negative 4 y squared times negative 6 y squared.
And then make sure, guys, make sure we combine our like terms in the middle. If you don't combine your like terms, you're going to take partial credit off. Okay, make sure we simplify all the way, so we gotta combine our like terms. Combine your like terms, please. Thank you. F is just another FOIL, just has fractions in it. Okay, so Chris Clue, can you do F for me?
Yeah.
My like terms in the middle simplify to it'd be -3x. So -1/2 -1 is -1/2 -2/2, which is
you should like -1.5.
Yeah. That's fine. Yeah, so I'll let Jack redeem himself.
No, that's what it
is. Oh, okay, that's what you're gonna kind of. Someone yesterday said that this equals x squared plus 2 squared. That does not equal x squared plus 2 squared. Don't do that. Don't do it. Don't do it. All right, don't do it, okay? So this is equal to x plus 2 times x plus 2, right? That's what it means for something to be squared. Multiply it by itself, okay? Then we FOIL. All right, so it's x squared plus 4x plus 4, okay? Notice, okay, here's two formulas I'm gonna give you. A plus b squared is gonna be, in general, a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, and then a minus b squared. Going to be a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. Okay. So either use these formulas, or if you forget the formulas, you can just write out x minus 4 times x minus 4. Okay. But do not put like x squared minus 4 squared. Okay. So this is going to be x squared minus 8x plus 16. Feel okay about this? All right. Monica DeSanto, can you see for me, please?
C?
Yeah.
X squared.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so she squared my first term here, this yellow term, and then she took my yellow term and my pink term, multiply them together and doubled it, right? So it became 7 times x, which is 7x. Doubling that gives us 14x. And then she added on the pink term squared. Okay? If you forget, if you want to be careful, you just literally just write out x plus 7 times x plus 7 and FOIL. Okay, it'll give you the same answer. Denia.
It's x squared minus 25.
Yeah, it's going to be, so if we FOIL, we get x squared minus 5x plus 5x minus 25, and then these are going to cancel, okay? X squared minus 25. Notice, what was the only thing that was different about these two binomials? One's a plus, one's a minus, right? When that's the case, your two like terms in the middle here are always going to cancel out, so your answers is going to be the first term squared minus the second term squared. Okay? You guys remember that from Algebra 1? Difference of squares. DOS, difference of squares. Okay? Right, if you want to remember that and do it really fast, you can. If you would rather just FOIL, you can do that too. Be careful. All right. So, I think I called him mostly. Right. Will Pletcher, can you be for me, please?
Yeah. Distribute 2x, y,
what are my like terms in the middle?
Yeah, so 12.
There you go. Thank you, Will. All right. So there's that. Anyone want to do C for me? No one wants to. Okay, then I will compel you to. All right, so Sam Rice, please do part C. Thank you, Mrs. Hollis. Right. Yeah. There you go. Yep. Thank you. If you want to do 0.25, you can do that. Love 1/4. Right, D, part D. Here's an interesting one. Anyone have any idea what you should do? Yes, Denia.
Wouldn't it be 36 and then you would then distribute the 2B minus 2 like the FOIL?
Yeah, so you could do that way. I think the easiest way for you guys, that's actually the way I would do it, but if I were you guys, though, you should probably just distribute the negative first and simplify what's inside your brackets and then square. Does that make any sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yeah, so this make this turn this into 6 minus 2b plus 4. All right. And then that becomes 10 minus 2b squared, right? That's the easiest way for you guys to do that one. Okay? Right. In 5 years or whatever, when you're more advanced, you can use... do what Denia was saying. All right, and then 10 minus 2b squared is the same as 10 minus 2b times 10 minus 2b, right? Which is first, right, first outer minus 20b, inner minus 20b, last, plus 4b squared. So 4b squared minus 40b plus 100. All right. Is it okay about that one? This one, whew. This one's a little, it's a bit of a doozy here. What do I do for this one? There's 3 binomials I'm multiplying together. What do I do for that one? Just FOIL. You got to FOIL. You got to FOIL twice, basically. So you got to pick 2 to multiply together at first. Okay, so we FOIL those. That gives me x squared minus 2x plus 3x minus 6. Okay, and then don't forget to drop down this 2x minus 1. You still got that guy just hanging out over there. Okay, combine my like terms, x squared plus x minus 6. Now, don't forget to pull this guy down. Keep pulling him down. Now I'm going to use the claw method. So Macy did this one right before lunch. Right? I do x squared times 2x. Right, I do x times 2x, and I do minus 6 times 2x. So that gives me 2x cubed plus 2x squared minus 12x. And then down here, right, I got to do x squared times minus 1, x times minus 1, and minus 6 times minus 1. So minus x squared minus x plus 1, right, or plus 6. And check my math. If I make a mistake, tell me. Then I combine like terms, right? My x squared terms I got to combine. I got my x terms I got to combine, right? That gives me 2x cubed and then plus x squared minus 13x plus 6. You guys see that? Okay, write that down. Once you have it written down, I'm going to erase it because I need more room for part B. Just get that written down, please. Yeah, what's up? 4? Alright, you guys okay if I erase that real quick? B, y minus 2 to the 4th. How about I do this one? Right, this is equal to what? What's y minus 2 to the 4th equal to?
Y minus 4 times.
Yeah. There is. Okay, yeah, there is. I'm not going to teach it to you, though. I tried teaching it to my Cal kids, and they were, like, completely lost. So it's called the binomial theorem, if you want me to try to learn it. Come in for office hours. I don't think I'm supposed to teach binomial theorem in this. Yeah. Yes, there's a shortcut you learn in pre-Cal. You get really good at if you keep using it. It's called the binomial theorem. If you could do, like, y minus 2 to the 10th, you could just do it, like, in your head. But anyway. We got to do it the long way, okay? Y minus 2 times y minus 2 times y minus 2 times y minus 2, okay? So let's just for the first two, right? That'll give me y squared minus 4y plus 4, okay? And because, okay, the green and the pink are the same thing, right? So they're both going to be equal to that. My B period actually told me. B period told me to do it this way instead. They said they like this way better, so. All right, you guys see that? Now it becomes like a mega claw, okay? So I gotta take y squared times y squared minus 4y times positive 4, okay? So that becomes y squared times y squared is y to the 4th, and then y squared times minus 4y is minus 4y cubed, and y squared times positive 4 is plus 4y squared. Okay, let's do the middle, so minus 4y times y squared, minus 4y times minus 4y, minus 4y times positive 4. So that gives me minus 4y cubed, and then plus 16y squared, minus 16y. Let's see where those blue terms came from. What color should I use for the other ones? Orange? And then I gotta do 4y squared and 4 times minus 4y and 4 times 4. So that gives me plus 4y squared minus 16y plus 16. All right.
Wait, I have one more question.
Yeah.
I know you're not gonna teach it to us, but like, is that a formula for it?
Formula for like what I just did?
Is it a shortcut? No, it's not.
The formula is the binomial theorem, which I'm not teaching in algebra.
Okay,
yeah, there is a formula, but we're not going to learn it in this class. Yep. Just got to do it the long way. All right, and then I got a bunch of like terms to combine. So be careful. Let's highlight all my y cubes. Okay, and let's highlight all my y squareds. Okay, and let's highlight all my y's. And then 16 and my y to the fourth don't have any like terms. So my final answer is y to the fourth. What do my y cubes simplify to? Negative 8y cubed, that's what I got. What do my y squared simplify to? Is that 24? What do my y simplify to? What do my, and my constant is just 16. Final answer, final answer. Sweet. Sweet deal. Sweet deal. What's that? Let's do C first. C is actually a good one for you guys to see. C, okay, I got a foil, okay? I got a foil, okay? Gotta do more foiling. Let's let's start by foiling out these two. What's not? Why is that not a good idea? Why should I start by foiling the first two together instead? This product right here that I just highlighted in pink, that's going to have two terms, right? Because the outer and inner are going to cancel. And then so I can just do regular foiling both times. I'll show you what I mean by that. Okay. So if I foil the first two first, right, that's going to give me x squared minus y squared. Okay, and then I just have to multiply that by x plus y. So now it's just regular foil. Right, so that gives me first is x cubed. Outer is plus x squared y, inner is minus xy squared, last is minus y cubed. Can I combine my like terms in the middle? Are those like terms in the middle?
No.
Why are they not like terms? They kind of look like it. Exponents are not. It has to be the exact same variables with the exact same exponents, which is not the case here, right? Okay, but so that's my final answer. All right, you feel okay about that? Let's go down to, what time does class get out, 15? Sweet, we got it. Good, good, good. Okay, let's go down to A. F of x equals x squared minus 2x. Find f of a. What's f of a? How do I plug something into a function? So if I have a function of x right here, right? I have a function of x. Yeah, so to plug in A means everywhere there's an X, I replace with an A. Okay, so what would that be? Yeah, F of A equals A squared minus 2A. Okay. What would F of C be? The exact same thing, except with a C. C squared minus 2C. Okay. What about F of A plus B? So, right, anywhere there's an x in my original function, I replace with an a plus b in parentheses. So it's a plus b squared minus 2 times a plus b. Okay. What's a plus b squared, Berhanu?
That would be 3. That would be
3. No, can you, what's this? Simplify.
A squared.
He said a squared plus b squared. What do we say? A plus b squared is, you forgot the 2ab. Yep, you're good. Just don't make it on the, don't make the mistake on a test, and then plus b squared, and then you said distribute the minus 2? Yes, it's minus 2a, minus 2b, okay.
Yeah, but
yeah.
So whenever you have ab together, you have to put 2 in front of it.
Like right here?
No.
Or right here?
Like a squared plus ab. It's not that way.
A squared, it's going to be a squared plus 2ab. A plus b, quantity squared, simplifies to a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. I don't know if that was what you were asking.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, and then do we have any like terms here? No, so that's just our answer. Yeah, good job. And then D, how do I plug A minus 2 into my function? How do I plug that in? A minus 2 squared minus 2 times A minus 2, right? Anytime there, anywhere there was an x, I just replaced it with an A minus 2 in parentheses, right? Okay. All right, Berhanu, redemption. What's A minus 2 quantity squared?
A squared.
Yep.
Minus 4. A.
And then... plus what?
Plus
4.
Four.
Okay. And then distribute the negative 2, right? What do I get when I distribute the negative 2?
Negative 2 and
yep.
Plus
4. Plus 4, yeah. But any like terms I can combine?
Yeah.
Yeah, a squared minus 6a plus 8. Hey, guys, good, really good job today. Really good job, okay? Any questions? Okay, so let's stop the video.